Talk to me about this new chip.
Great to be here. 3D XPoint is a persistent memory. What we mean by that is that it is a kind of memory that is giving you faster speeds than NAND memory, than flash memory, and chip densities that are higher than DRAM memory. It is really ideally suited for data center applications, suited for both memory as well as storage. So this is to accelerate deep learning kind of workloads that require high speeds. What we introduced today is a solid state drive that is the fastest drive in the world that we introduced. So very exciting.
Is this really banking on the future of the cloud?
3D XPoint memory is a technology that works well in data center applications. Of course, it is a technology that can also be deployed to other end market applications, such as mobile or other intelligent devices on the edge. But no doubt, data center is a big opportunity because the trends of artificial intelligence today are absolutely requiring ability to process a lot of data, gain more insight from the data, unlock greater value. That means you have to be able to have memory and storage solutions, which is what Micron makes. We are the only company in the Western Hemisphere that makes semiconductor memory and storage solutions. You have to store data, you have to access it fast, you have to process it fast. It needs the kind of solutions Micron makes. And yes, they go not only in cloud applications, data center applications, but all the intelligent devices at the edge, from smartphones to automobiles.
You know, you had previously been working with Intel on this. Why the move to go it alone?
Well, we have a great opportunity here to control our own destiny. And with respect to technology and manufacturing capabilities, we had partnership and a joint venture before. Now we have opportunity to bring the technology to a broad set of applications and manage our technology roadmap, product roadmap, as well as manufacturing capabilities in line with our business objectives.
You talk a lot about smartphones. How much of a tailwind are we expecting from 5G? Can you incorporate that into your analysis?
5G absolutely will be a growth driver for next many years to come. 5G is not only about smartphones. 5G is also about machine-to-machine connectivity that really on the edge is going to bring about many, many devices that will be connected with each other, intelligent devices that are able to collect more data. Within smartphone, no question that 5G phones with their low latency and high speeds are able to give you access to data and give you rich experiences. So for example, imagine a 360 degree immersive experience that you can watch on your phone, watch different perspectives of a game that's being broadcast to you. That then, in order to manipulate all of that on your smartphone, it needs more memory, it needs more storage. At Mobile World Congress, 12 gigabyte of DRAM smartphones were announced in February of this year, and a terabyte of storage was announced in the phones as well.
And one of the phones that has 5G already is Huawei. How are your relationships with Huawei right now?
With respect to the U.S.-China trade relations, with respect to the entity listing of Huawei, we have said publicly that it has impacted our opportunity with Huawei. They are an important and a large customer of Micron's. We are very global. We are engaged with a well-diversified set of customers with our memory and storage solutions that go into very many different end market opportunities. So our revenues with Huawei, as we said in our earnings call in September, are less than what they would have been if Huawei was not placed on the entity listing.
And are you actively working with the Trump administration to clarify any confusion about licenses to apply for, how to get around some of the export bans?
So we also said in our September earnings call that we have applied for licenses. Of course, licenses have not been granted yet. You will know it, you know, when they get granted. And we said that without grant of licenses, it will potentially lessen our opportunities with Huawei in terms of future business with them. But point is that we are a company with a diversified portfolio and a very broad set of customers all across the globe.
And I want to tie that into a chart here that I'm showing in my Bloomberg terminal to our audience, which shows your total revenue. And then, of course, a portion of that, just under half or so, coming from China. So you say that you're a global company. Where else can you start to shift that revenue, given all the headwinds coming from China?
Yeah, I think what's important to understand is that we are a global company and a lot of our customers that are based outside of China take delivery of their product in China for their supply chain considerations. So I think the numbers you are looking at are really related also to that aspect. If you look at Chinese headquartered companies, you know, as we have recently reported in our 10K, Chinese headquartered company, our revenue is approximately 20%. And with respect to Huawei, yes, they have been the largest customer on fiscal year 19 that we ended, approximately 12%. So, you know, with a well-diversified set of customers, these customers may take their supply in China, but we are engaged with them elsewhere as well.
Finally, in your business, we know it all comes down to the prices of NAND and DRAM. And if you bear with me, I'm going to show one more chart here for our Bloomberg audience, which is your share price, Micron, rising. But NAND prices have been diverging. We thought we'd see bottoming out NAND and DRAM. What do you see? Are we at the bottom? Do we start to see NAND and DRAM prices start to tick up higher?
So we talked about this also recently in our September earnings call.
But we want new news here. Give us some new news.
We did say that, you know, NAND has started seeing price increases. That's what we had discussed. And, you know, of course, NAND market, you know, with the price elasticity that it has, you know, more and more of solid-state drives are being used in notebook computers. Attach rate is increasing as well as the content is increasing. On the DRAM side, your end market demand drivers continue to be secular in nature, whether it's your data center or it's your smartphone or PC or even in industrial applications, automobiles, etc. You're needing more DRAM. So we had said that yes, there is some excess supply in the market right now, but what's important is that the supply growth in the industry in DRAM is less than the demand growth, which means this inventory that may be there is now coming down rapidly, and therefore it's a matter of time before I believe DRAM will also be in a good place.